हेलो, आई एम स्वर्णाली भुइया एंड टुडे आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग ऑन द टॉपिक क्रिप्टोग्राफी। नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ व्हाट इज क्रिप्टोग्राफी। हियर कम्स द डेफिनेशन, दैट इज क्रिप्टोग्राफी इज द साइंस ऑफ प्रोटेक्टिंग इंफॉर्मेशन बाय ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग इट इनटू अ सिक्योर फॉर्मेट। नाउ व्हाट इज दिस सिक्योर फॉर्मेट? दिस सिक्योर फॉर्मेट आर कोड्स, दैट इज आर plain text is converted into code languages, and these code languages will not be easily read or understood by the unauthorized person in the network, and hence it protects, that is the secure format. And this process by which this text and information is protected is called encryption, that is the process by which the plain text is converted into ciphers or cipher text, etc. These are known as, this process is known as encryption. Now, in today's world, encryption is used to protect digital data. In simple terms, you can say that it is the method of maintaining privacy, better digital privacy and cyber protection, of course. Now, what are cryptograms? It is the type of puzzles that consists pieces of encrypted text. Also, it's known as the communication in ciphers or codes. Now, this is what a cipher or cryptograms look like. Can you understand anything from this? No, right? This is how we protect our text. This is how we convert it into code languages, and no one will be able to understand until and unless we decrypt it. Now let's move on to the aims of cryptography. Now what are the aims or the objectives, main objectives of cryptography? There are 4 points, that is confidentiality, integrity, authenticity and non-repudiation. Confidentiality, this is very common. This ensures that only the intended recipient, that is the person which we want to send the message, can only that person can only read the message and its contents. And integrity, this ensures that the message cannot be modified while sending or while storage. And authenticity, this ensures that the sender and the recipient can verify each other's identity. That is, if I send a message to my friend, then I should know that I am sending message to my friend, and the friend should know that I am sending the message, right? Now comes non-repudiation. This non-repudiation means that the sender of the message, that is I cannot backtrack and deny that I have not sent the message. This is also important, right? Now let's move on to the crypto system. This whole thing, this whole picture is the crypto system. Now it consists of the sender here, the receiver, and an interceptor, an unauthorized person who is trying to see what I am sending to my friend. Let's say I am the sender over here and I am trying to send a message to my friend. Here, my friend is the receiver. Now, how will I send the message from me to my receiver, that is to my friend? Through internet, right? And this internet is not a very secure channel. Any unauthorized person will be able to see what I am sending over to my friend, and I do not want the unauthorized person here, the interceptor, to read or understand what am I sending to my friend. So what can I do? One way is that I can convert the text into an unreadable form, that is in coded form, so that the interceptor will not be able to understand what am I saying. Even though if he reads what am I saying, he will not be able to understand. Now, what this crypto system consists of, what this crypto system ensures is that I will be sending my message in plain text, right? What is plain text now? This plain text is the text or information that anyone can send and understand. That is, in normal word, the normal language we communicate. Now, this plain text will not be sent over to my receiver friend as it is. We are going to encode it. Now, how we are going to code it? Using encryption algorithms. Now, these encryption algorithms will convert this plain text into coded text. Now, this coded text, we call it as cipher text. How will it convert? With the use of encryption algorithm and with the help of keys. These keys are very important. Now, this cipher text will be sent over to the receiver part. Now, how it will be sent over to the internet? This encrypted cipher text will be decrypted by using the decryption algorithm. Same algorithm which I am using here, I am going to decrypt it, and then it will be converted into plain text again, and this plain text will be sent over to my friend, and that friend will be able to understand the text, what am I sending. In the meanwhile, this interceptor will not be able to understand any of this thing, any of the text, cipher text which I am sending, because he doesn't have the encryption key. The key which is used to see or decode this cipher text, right? This is what the crypto system or cryptography mainly is. Now comes, what are ciphers? I have told you here that this is the cipher text or cipher, right? Now what are these? The cipher is an algorithm which is applied to plain text to get cipher text. Simple coded text is the cipher text, right? Now, what are the types of ciphers? We have Caesar cipher, monoalphabetic cipher, homophonic substitution cipher, polygram substitution cipher, polyalphabetic substitution cipher, Playfair cipher, Hill cipher. These are the types of ciphers. That is, these are the types of coded, you can say coded text. Now let's move on to the types of cryptography. Now what are the types of cryptography? Three types: secret key cryptography, public key, and hash functions. These are pretty much over it. Now comes the uses of cryptography. The uses of cryptography include secrecy in transmission. That is, the messages which we are sending are being protected or not. The secrecy in storage, we do not want to show what our storage includes. Integrity in transmission, authentication of identity, that yes, I am sending my message to someone else. Digital signatures, yes, the signature belongs to me only and nobody else. Electronic money, it's very important to secure electronic money, right? Secure multi-party computation. These are some of the uses of cryptography. That's all about cryptography, and thank you.